Hey, what's up guys? Welcome back to another H1Z1 video. Today we are playing Ignition, as always. And yeah, you guys should know how the game works. I've explained it a lot in a lot of videos. So, yeah, today we're just going to get into the game. I am rocking my soda poppin' shirt right now and some tie-dye pants. The safe zones are pretty close to us, which is very, very useful because we'll have a lot more time to loot instead of drive around for the safe zone. A lot of times, if the safe zone is like two to four minutes away, we only get maybe like a couple minutes of looting. We'll get a good solid 5 to 6 minutes of looting, and we're next to a town. So this is really, really good. We have a good chance of getting a lot of loot, do ourselves some good, which will be great. Now, I'm having a little bit of lag. Guys, this game is not amazingly optimized, so if you guys see a couple stutters here and there, I'm sorry. It's really not my fault. If you guys look at my computer is just fine. I can handle almost any game. I can handle Arma and Ultra, but yeah, this game is just... This game is something, and that flip was completely calculated. 100% calculated. But yeah, if you guys see a couple stutters, if you see a lot of big frame drops, sorry about that. Can't do much. There's a guy with an ATV behind me. Now, we got to be careful of him. I actually don't think he has a gun yet, so he won't be too much danger. But we do have to grab ourselves a gun. There's a helmet. There is probably the worst pistol that I could grab. But it'll do well to defend us just for now. Unless he gets an AR. But then I just give up on the game, so it's okay. Yeah, let's check this building right here. Is there anybody around us? Just to make sure. Gotta make sure there's not a million people around us. So yeah, we have about 6 minutes until detonation. That gives us plenty of time to loot the building. Now I'm just gonna hope for an AR, because if we don't get an AR, we'll have to fight someone with either a shotgun or a pistol, which is never super, super fun. And there's an AR right there. But yeah... looks like someone already took the ammo, sadly, so someone's probably been in this building. But they did leave the Magnum ammo, or the Magnum 2. And I love myself the Magnum. You can blow up cars with it very, very easily. If you guys don't know, Magnums actually do extra damage to cars compared to other things. I think it does like 8% or even higher. So yeah, the Magnum is super effective against cars. Maybe if the car is like halfway broken, you can blow it up and... an entire clip. If it's brand new, you can blow it up in 2 clips if you obviously hit every shot. But there we go, there is an AR that is usable with some ammo, and there's an AK. So we'll go ahead, get rid of that stupid pistol, because we got AK and an AR in the house, so we'll be doing just fine. There is some duct tape. We will grab that just in case we find an extra military backpack. We will be able to make some makeshift armor. And we did also find more AR ammo, which is nice. There, forget about the makeshift ammo, because we don't need that. We got a Lammy going on. That means, guys, that I'll be able to soak up a bunch more shots, which will be nice. That could very, very easily save my life. Usually, if someone isn't good and they don't go for headshots, they'll go for body shots. And if you don't have a Lammy, you could probably pop about 3 to 4 shots if you get lucky. With the Lammy, you could probably take 6 to 7 to 8 if you get lucky, so the Lammy will help me quite a lot. Now, I'm hearing a lot of cars outside, and I'm hearing lots and lots of shots. So, I know there's people around me, so I do have to be careful. What I think I'm going to do here is, I'm in a building that's very, very safe, and I do have the advantage if anyone wants to come up here. So, I know this is going to seem kind of newbie and terrible, but I'm actually going to camp this house. As you guys see, if you look at up where it says the amount of time and it's going to detonate, if it's red, we're not in the detonation zone. If it's green, we are. At this moment, we are in the detonation zone, so we are good. So really, I just have to stay in this house and stay alive. Now, what would be amazing is if people came into the house, then I could kill them. But if they don't come in the house, I'm really not going to hunt them down, because there's no point. If I was an amazing player, I would go out and hunt and do it just for the kills, but I'm here more for the wins, not the kills. Wins, kills are nice, but yeah. Hopefully they come up here. If they don't, then I guess it just happens. But of course, not everyone's going to die in this circle. There's going to be more circles, so we'll have more opportunities to kill some people. But guys, we're Actually, right now we're amazing. We have a helmet, we have a Lammy, we have an AK and an AR, and we have plenty of medical supplies, so at this moment we really don't need anything else. That's another reason why I'm not going outside and fighting. If I go ahead and fight, they might take my Lammy off, they might take my helmet off, they might even kill me. So right now I have some very, very good stuff. There's no point in losing it and wasting it. If I can survive until top 3, top 5, and have this stuff, that's going to be an easy win for us. So detonation is going to be in still 2 minutes, so we'll just have to wait it out. Alright guys, so let's make our way out of here. Detonation is in almost 6 minutes. We have plenty of time to get there, but let's kind of scout around, see what's going to go on. You guys can see the green circle right there. That's where we need to be, so it's not that far. Now, I would explain how the map works to you guys, but I'm kind of in the middle of everything. If you guys want to know how the map works, essentially, on the map, it works just like usual. North is up, east is right. South is down, and I forgot the last one. Northeast, southwest. West is to your left. And up in the corner, you guys can see which way I'm facing. Right now, it's southwest, south, southeast, east, northeast. So, really, essentially, you just got to look on the map, see where the green circle is. If you look on the bottom right, you can see my position is D5. So, really, all I have to do is find my position on the map, see where I need to go. If it's north, I just move my body until I see north, and I head that way. That's essentially just how you do it. Now, got ourselves a truck, which is nice. I will gladly take this truck and use it. So now, really, there are only 8 players left. We have plenty of time to get to the save zone. We have plenty of equipment. So far, we're doing quite nicely. We'll see what's going to happen here. Hopefully we'll get into some fights and kill some people. Might be dangerous though, but we will see what's going to happen. The great thing is we do have a truck now. We don't have to stay with an ATV, because with an ATV, you tend to be very out in the open, and I do not want that to happen. A truck will give me some protection. If someone's shooting at my head, I can just get out of the car and duck below it, which is nice. Now we want to see how many people are here. Kind of get a census of what's going on. So it doesn't look like there's too many people here right now. Let's put on this biofuel, just because why not? Might as well put it on, because I don't want to get in the middle of a fight and accidentally run out of fuel and then be stuck and have to take the fight. I'd rather just have the fuel now and see what's going to happen later on. So of course we still do have 3 minutes until it happens. So probably people aren't going to be showing up for a good little bit just yet. So we'll just have to wait, I guess. Alright guys, so let's take our car down. We only have a minute until detonation, so let's just take our car down there. We should just get in the zone just to make sure we're not gonna blow up. That's happened many times. And I see a person in the bush right there. I see you, dude. I see you. You are, if you don't move, you're dead. Bink. And we just murdered a guy with our pickup truck. Now see, if he would have stood up, he could have shot my head and killed me. But no, he decided to just stay in the bush. So it's completely fine with me. I will take them out with my truck. Didn't even have to use my car, which is nice. So the detonation is in less than 30 seconds. There are plenty of cars here, which is kind of interesting. And we'll see what we can do. There's a person over here on this hill, but the problem is he does have his gun out. Well, I tried to go for him in a terrible way, but the thing is, he did kind of scare me. He did have his gun out, and if I get close to him, he can headshot me through my window. That does happen, so I wanted to make sure that did not happen. So it looks like there's a couple ATVs running around also, which is kind of cool. There's two cop cars in front of me. Now, what I do want to make sure is I don't get T-boned by another car, because if two cars crash and they end up just staying together and not moving, I'm going to have to get out of my car to kill him, because he'll get out of his car. Now, what you guys are hearing right now, the AK, is actually a glitch. Sometimes if you shoot a gun, and I don't know why it happens, but sometimes you stop shooting the gun and the sound actually still plays. So I'm pretty sure the AK noises were actually just a glitch. The AR shots were actual real shots. Now, the drop is right in the middle of the field. Now, I don't think I'm going to go for it, because really the only thing special I can get out of there is the sniper. And I'm not very good with the sniper. I haven't played with it quite a lot, really. Now, you can get medical supplies and ammo, but I really don't need those. But what I am going to do is, the safe zone is very, very near us. There's no point for me to rush to it. The crate, though, some people are going to want to get at just because they're greedy. So I do want to camp the crate a little bit to see if anyone kind of gets out and tries to go for it. Because if they do, I'm going to try to kill them, obviously. Now, it looks like this cop car has a little bit of interest in it, considering he's kind of wrapping around it like me. I don't know if he thinks that I want it too, but I don't. But I guess we'll see. Now, I heard some shots over there, so that means there's at least two people there. There's one in the cop car and one shooting. There are five players left. So there, we do have the position of two of them. Two of them are in front of me, and the other two are probably at the safe zone. I'm just going to give a fair guess that they're probably there. Now, let's see what we can do about these people. There was one dude. Wow, okay. If you guys hear that sound, that is the noise of a sniper rifle. So we do have to be careful not to get shot by that. Alright, and there's a guy in the hill right here now. Oh, he's shooting at me. I gotta be careful. I couldn't have ran him over. I wasn't going fast enough, and I didn't even realize he was there until the last minute. But alright, we have one guy without a car. We have one guy in a police car. And we have probably two at the safe zone already. So, yeah, we have to be careful. Now, I think I'm just gonna drive away now, because I don't know what I'll be able to do. The thing that scares me is if there's two people over there by the crate. I know one of them is a sniper. I know one of them has a sniper rifle, and I don't want to get caught up in that, because even if I try to fight him, one shot to my head will go through my helmet and maybe kill me. I do not want to do that. So I'm just gonna back off. I'm not gonna take that fight. There's no reason to take that fight. If I get lucky and find the one without the sniper rifle, I could maybe kill him, but there's no point. It's okay. We can play this safe. We're going for the win, not exactly the kills. So we'll just take a safe. Let's just go to the safe zone and chill out here. And eventually, hopefully, the guy with the sniper rifle dies. If he doesn't die, it'll be a 1v1, me against a sniper rifle. And honestly, I say I'm scared of the sniper rifle, but I'm really not. I can still be able to kill a guy with it. I have before, and I will again if I have to, really. Now, another person has died. We only have four people left. So, alright, I see a guy in the bushes right there. We could try to go for him, but again, I'm very hesitant about going up to people not on car with a car, because they can shoot through the windows, and I've had that happen to me many, many times, and I actually lost him, but he's shooting at my car, so gotta be careful. I actually lost him. I don't know where he even went, but apparently he saw me, because obviously I'm in a very, very loud truck. Now, the detonation is still in a minute. Still four people left. And soon, guys, there's going to be four people in this tiny, tiny circle, so I'll have to really be careful, watch my head a little bit. And there is a guy without a car. He is honestly the most dangerous one, because if there's someone else in a car, you can't shoot from a car. So really, I can drive next to them, around them. They won't really be a danger. The only way they'll be a danger is if they actually get out of the car. But by then, I'll probably be driven away by now and they couldn't hit me. But the guy that's not in a car, he always knows where I am. He's always ready to shoot. So that's the guy I really need to be careful of. Now, we have everybody in sight. There's two with cop cars, and there's one with nothing. He just has a gun. So I do have to be careful. I'm just gonna pray that he starts shooting at the two with cop cars and not me. The thing is, I'm not gonna say this as fact, because it's not fact, but I've seen this a lot happens, is if there's maybe like four people, and let's just say three of them all have cars, two of them have Jeeps, one of them is a cop car, usually the cop car gets shot at. If there's two Jeeps and one truck, usually the truck gets shot at. If there's two trucks and one Jeep, the Jeep gets shot at. So usually, I don't know, just from my experience, it always happens, or it seems to happen. So there's two cop cars and one truck, so I'm probably gonna get shot at. Wow, look at that foreshadowing. I got shot at, and I actually did get hit. Now, I didn't take a lot of damage, now I'm just bleeding. But the ring actually goes away in, like, right now, so we'll be able to get away and heal, which will be completely fine. It's nothing we have to worry about. Now, what we do have to worry about is we only got about 14% gas. So that gas has to get us all the way there. Now, someone could probably kill me from here, but I do need a bandage up. And I'm just going to hope they're not paying attention to me. So yeah, we have about 2 minutes to get to that save zone. You guys actually just saw it drop in the background. So it's not too far away. Now, I know two people are still here. There's still one in the cop car, and there's still that one guy in the distance with no car just shooting by the trees. Now, where did this cop car go? If it's pretty close, I do want to try my chance at him. Okay, it looks like the cop car and the guy are down there. Alright, so I see a guy, I see a cop car. Let's see if I can try to hit him. Nope, I am... I'm not going to say I potatoed, but I just didn't hit him. Because that wasn't a potato. That's a fairly hard shot to hit. But yeah, I do need to get to the save zone. We only have less than 3 minutes. I am full health. I only have 12% gas, though, so I do need to hurry up to that place. Now, hopefully this will be a good circle, because this is where the game is going to end. Usually, when there's a lot of people in a circle, someone stays alive, but we only have four people. And as you guys know, every single time a new circle pops up, it gets smaller and smaller. And obviously, the closer everybody gets, the more chances of you guys being very, very aggressive. So I'm going to predict that this is going to be the finale right here. If this is a good circle for me, if I can get in a good position, it'll be my game. If I don't, it'll be bad. So we do have a truck. There's still the two guys with cop cars, and there's still the guy that's probably going to be running over here. There is dead bags on the floor, probably with... Oh, and there's a guy up here. I'm not going to challenge him because he's out of his car. He'll be able to shoot me through the window. So I'm going to describe this circle a little bit. This is going to be a fairly awkward circle because it has one elevated point and one low point. Now, there's one guy in the elevated point that is going to stop everybody else from getting on the high point. I only have three fuel left. Two. I'm going to be stuck. This is a bad, bad position. I'm going to be stuck down here if I don't get up there. But the guy up there is already up there. So even if I kill him, I'll be wounded and some other guy's going to come and try to pick me off. So really, I got to play a game of Canyon. Now, this little dugout right here is probably the safest place for me to stay. Guys, this might easily be the end of the game because, yeah, there's a guy above me. There's a guy right there to my side. And then there's a guy. So here's what's going to happen. If the guy from above sees me, he's going to kill me. The only good part is, like I said, I'm in this little dugout where only the guys from the bottom can see me. The guy from the top actually can't see me, which is really nice. He doesn't even know I'm here. So I'll be able to kill the lower guys here while the guy above me actually kills them too. Now, these guys down here can kill me also, which would be kind of dangerous. So I gotta play this very, very smart. Now, my truck is gonna get blown up soon, so I actually gotta run away from it. I'm gonna have to go out in the open. It's just what I'm gonna have to do. But the good thing is, the guy from the top actually can't shoot me. The only people that can shoot me is from the bottom. So as long as the guy from the top actually kills the two behind me, I'll be good to go. Now, it doesn't look like anybody's targeting me at the moment. One has exploded. It looks like Dax. Oh, and there's a guy. I'll be able to get this guy right here. One guy's exploded. There's one guy below me, one guy above me. This guy doesn't know I'm here, so I'm gonna take him out. Now, the only person left is a guy below me, which now I have the advantage. I am on top of the hill. I actually have cover. He does not have cover. I have a gigantic advantage. Now, what I'm going to do to exploit my advantage is I'm actually going to go higher up in the hill. Now, if he was smart, he'd go directly to the safe zone and not try to challenge me, but it'd be nice if he did challenge me. Now, there goes my truck, and now I can see he is going to challenge me because he's firing shots. So he is trying to come at me now. Like I keep saying over, I do have a good advantage because I am above him. Now, we have only 50 seconds to get to the safe zone, but it looks like he's coming after me. This is going to be a 1v1 death situation. We are not going to go to safe zone. It is going to end right here. Now, if I potato, it'll be bad. If I don't potato, So far, potatoing, but hit me once. 1, 2, 3, 4, and he's dead. And there is our game. That was awesome, guys. That was insane. Whew, guys, I'm not gonna lie. I was super scared there when my truck ran out of fuel. But we ended up making some good plays. The one guy above us didn't notice that I was coming for him. So yeah, guys, that was amazing. I don't know how many kills I got that game. I think 2 or 3, 4. Let's actually, we can check right here. How many kills did we get? We got 3. Alright, but guys, if you guys did enjoy, make sure to like and comment as this was the channel. And I'll see you guys later. God bless, and goodbye.